Good morning. My name is Alice Gaines. I am here to brag on God. How can I not say something to God about the God I serve? Because he's been so good to me. I want to get right to how I was. You see me as Sister Gaines, the perfect little pastor's wife, always with a smile, but that wasn't always the case. I'm here to be real and tell you how God saved me when he met me, and the day that my world became a reality and not something that I had made up. I didn't know God. I thought I knew him. I read the Bible since I was a little kid, because my father and mother made sure we had biblical books and pictures in our house, and I read them like comic books. But I didn't understand the New Testament. It didn't appeal to me. But my life had turned on me. I had such hatred for people, all people. I had anger and rage. I was screaming at him, saying that I go to church Sunday after Sunday and do all these church things, but I don't know you. I don't know if you exist. I've never seen you or heard you. I read about you and I enjoy the stories, but I don't know who you are. If you're real, make yourself real to me. Now that I look back, I was having some mental issues. In those days, people didn't really recognize it as quickly as these days. I said to him, "Do I belong to you?" And there was a silence. And that meant no. I knew that silence meant no. And I said, "Well, why? I go to church every Sunday. I don't miss a Sunday. And I sing, I teach, and I do all of this. Why don't I belong to you?" In his silence, I heard that I didn't love people. I had no love. And I asked God, "Oh, well, change me, do whatever you have to do." I don't know what happened after that. I do remember this. A cousin, a teenage cousin, lived with me. And when he was coming from church, he said, he saw me coming and he said, "Who is that? Who is that?" He said, "Alice, is that you?" And I said, "Yes." He said, "You're smiling." And I said, "Yes, I am." Well, the point is that I never smiled. I hated myself. I hated all those people. I had such hatred. Couldn't smile. But God changed all of that, and I became brand new. That was the most beautiful thing that ever happened to me. And I felt it. I felt him. For the first time I heard him, I felt him. And it's been that way ever since. I also wanted brag on God and thank him for giving me the best husband in the whole world. I really impacted my life every day. There isn't a day go by right now that I don't think about him and how he brought joy, laughter, and celebration into my life. I want to thank God for my one and only, our own only daughter, Galen, that we both love dearly. I want to say Happy New Year. to all the people that I know and love, and Happy New Year, a happy, healthy New Year. I pray that 2022 will be a healthy New Year for us all. And that's my brag on God.